I wanted to share what I've learned about interpreting the EGFR number that you can probably find if you have a copy of your routine blood work. But before explaining EGFR, I need to talk about her overbearing big sister, GFR.
GFR is a number that gives you a hint about your kidneys. You'll notice I'm avoiding telling you what it stands for, and that is because I hate pronouncing this word. The whole phrase has more R and L sounds than I think should be legal. So I'll just call it GFR for the moment. And GFR is really about these members of the kidney called nephrons, who I picture as these soldiers on the front lines of your blood and your urine. And you've got maybe a million of these guys. I don't think this is actually a million, but I can't count any higher. Now, these nephrons have a flaw that I notice in a lot of people, and that is that they can die. And short of a biopsy or something, it's not like you can just take out your kidneys to see how the nephrons are holding up. So it's fortunate that they have a way of leaving clues for us. If we look at this area of them called the renal corpuscle, which is from renal, meaning relating to the kidneys, and from corpuscle, meaning Indonesian death metal band, from corpuscle, meaning a rounded globular mass of cells. So here's our rounded mass of cells in the kidney, and these little squiggly blood vessels are called, oh boy, capillaries. And they're receiving blood, but it's under a lot of pressure, so it's squeezed out through these filters as a kind of proto-urine. Luckily, the nephron has this thing to catch that proto-urine. It's usually called Bowman's capsule in honor of Sir William Bowman, who discovered it. I think in more modern terms, we'd probably call it Bowman's super-duper diaper. He seems like he was a playful guy that would appreciate a joke like that. Now, there's a lot that happens later that I'm leaving out of this, where the nephron feels guilty about peeing away valuable things and gobbles them back up. But for the purposes of understanding GFR, this first stage of squiggly diaper peeing is all we care about. That's what blah, blah, blah filtration is. And it's reported in a volume per time and area, which makes it a rate. The higher that rate, the more peeing is going on across all those nephrons in your kidneys. And that's more useful to know than you might think, because we know that only live nephrons can pee, and that the healthier they are, the more fiercely they can fill those diapers. This is a ridiculous video. But watching for that level of aliveness is important, because it surprised me to learn that if a nephron dies, it's gone. Unless you're one of these grumpy-looking frowny fishes, you're stuck with the nephron supply that you grew way back in the womb. There might be some promising developments on this from these rolly-chair researcher type of people, but nothing to count on. Now, fortunately, the size of your nephron army is huge relative to what you need, which is why you can afford to donate a kidney. You've got so many of these excess troops that you can afford to help someone else's war effort. But having that excess of troops is actually tricky in one way, because they could be dying off in droves due to some serious problem, and it might be a while before you get enough symptoms to notice it and to take action. I saw that you might lose 3/4 of your nephrons without it being noticeable. And that's not to mention a pretty solid theory that the more nephrons that die, the more pressure it puts on the remaining ones, potentially killing them off faster too. Now, I realize I've just thrown out a lot of scary and violent metaphors. I don't actually think this is something most people need to worry about. And if you have one of the things that would commonly cause these kidney problems, your doctor is already going to know to keep an eye on it. I just think, as with every other number on blood tests, it can be cool to see it not as this abstract report card that's judging you, but as a report on real events in the crazy world we carry around inside of us. And that if you address things that affect GFR, like high blood pressure or untreated diabetes, it'll help support those warriors in your violent nephron warfare. Which I am going to send a corpuscle for their next song title. Oh, this might be a bad time. I'm warned I'm not to hang around that dragon. Anyway, I hope that explains why GFR would be nice to know in general, because we could catch kidney problems while the nephrons were still alive, and maybe even when they're capable of recovery. But the really good ways of measuring GFR are too annoying to use for anything but research. There's these radioactive injections or these urine collection jugs that they always seem to design so you'll confuse it with your orange juice. So in the common testing world, everyone just uses tests that approximate GFR, and that's what I'll talk about in the next video, specifically the EGFR from your regular old blood tests. And I will also tell you EGFR's dark secret.
I'm going to put the little channel subscribe box thing up here. If I can get 100 subscribers, I think it is, YouTube will let me reserve a clean channel URL as opposed to the horrible monstrosity I have right now. And if that's not of interest to you, I will put a link to the 17th best video on YouTube right below it.